On a sunny day in Las Vegas, Nevada, it's the Mountain West Championship game. From the Thomas and Mack Center, the 6-seed New Mexico takes on 5th-seeded San Diego State. A look at how we got here, and for the Lobos, about to play their 4th game in the last 4 days. And hi, everyone. Welcome to Las Vegas with former Villanova head coach Steve Lapis. I'm Andrew Catalan. We'll hear from Evan Washburn coming up. Championship game, and we've got a championship atmosphere lap. This place is ready to go.
Well, it's been a banner year for the Mountain West. 6 teams under 35 in the net. Probably a good chance to get 6 teams in the bracket tomorrow in the NCAA tournament. So it's been a heck of a year.
At 24 hours from now, we will have a bracket. Both these teams figured to be in as we take a look at the starting lineups. And for New Mexico, Jalen House has had quite a week, averaging 21 points per game. While for San Diego State, Jaden Ledee, 34 in the quarterfinals and 22 in yesterday's semifinal victory. Richard Pitino, in his third season as the New Mexico head coach, his team with a 25-9 record. Going against Brian Dutcher, now in his 7th season with the Aztecs, 24-9 for the team that went to the national championship game a year ago. Our officials, Vern Harris, Michael Irving, and Greg Nixon. And we are underway with New Mexico controlling the opening tip.
You know, one thing I can tell you, San Diego State will play all man-to-man. If they play any zone, something's wrong. One thing you got to keep an eye on, they're going to switch every pick and roll. And one thing about New Mexico, they pick and roll a ton.
Great defense by Jay Powell. A block, and then he forced the missed shot. It'll stay with the Lobos. Illinois has held on to beat Nebraska, so the Illini advance to the Big Ten championship game against Wisconsin tomorrow on CBS. Jamal Mashburn Jr. puts the Lobos on the board.
And there's the negative. They switched. Jaden Ledee was on Mashburn. Obviously, Mashburn saw that and just shot it on him. San Diego State likes to switch all the time, but these guards are quick. Got to watch that.
Here's Jaden Ledee, bounces it in the corner to Lamont Butler with the shot clock down to 5.
And interesting, New Mexico decided to double Ledee from the perimeter, not only when he's on the block.
Butler misses, and the rebound is grabbed by Mashburn Jr. Great crowd here at the Thomas and Mack Center. Both these fan bases travel so well. Here is Dent on the baseline, had it poked away. Taken right back by House. And the NCAA's active career steals leader lays it in.
He was the defensive player of the year by the media in this league. He's been stealing the ball in this league forever.
Micah Parrish step back is good, and the Aztecs have their first field goal.
Micah Parrish, a lot bigger than the perimeter guys for New Mexico, just shot over him that time.
Nelly Jr. Joseph.
Normally, San Diego State tremendous at stopping the dribbler. That time, the dribbler gets into the lane way too easy. Boy, they're coming after Ledee quickly.
Tremell for 3. Welcome to Las Vegas. It's the Mountain West Championship game between the number 6-seed New Mexico Lobos and the 5th-seeded San Diego State Aztecs. Just over 2.5 minutes in, and New Mexico has a 6-5 lead. And that ball goes out of bounds. It'll stay with the Lobos. Here's a look at the starting lineups brought to you by Progressive. Jalen House has averaged 21 points per game this week for the Lobos. And for San Diego State, Jaden Ledee on a tear. He leads the Mountain West in scoring at 21 points per game. Richard Pitino in his third season as the Lobos head coach. And a turnover by his New Mexico squad. There's Brian Dutcher in his seventh season. And this is the seventh consecutive year San Diego State is playing in the Mountain West Championship game.
Yeah, let's face it, they've owned this event for a long time.
Looking for their record eighth title. Lamont Butler inside, knocked away, and here comes Jamal Baker on the break.
They got Dent out of the game pretty quickly, not feeling great.
Donovan Dent battling flu-like symptoms. Evan Washburn will have more on that in a moment as Nelly Jr. Joseph has his second field goal.
And you got to take that left shoulder away from him. Ledee's got to overplay that and make him go the other way.
6-0 in the paint in favor of the Lobos.
They're number five in the nation in paint points, 42 a game.
Yeah, 50% of their points are in the paint as Jay Powell says, welcome to Vegas.
Well, you know how everybody says in the modern game, you don't shoot a lot of twos? They shoot more twos than anybody in the country, New Mexico. 45 a game.
JT Toppin lost a handle on it. The Mountain West co-freshman of the year now goes up with it and scores. And what a first season for Toppin. 12 and a half points per game and 9 rebounds, which is second best in the league.
He was great yesterday, especially in the second half. 16, 9, and 3 blocks.
A high-octane start here in Las Vegas. Trammell catch-and-shoot 3. Comes up short. He was looking for a foul, and now we have a whistle behind the play. This crowd is electric. New Mexico and San Diego State playing for a championship. New Mexico out to an early lead here in Las Vegas on San Diego State. As you take a look at the tournament bracket here in the Mountain West, and the big story, New Mexico is the first team in tournament history to go from the first round on Wednesday all the way to the championship game, playing their fourth game in 4 days. As we take a look at the Fast Analysis presented by AT&T.
Well, let me tell you this. The Four Tops wrote a song about San Diego State. It's the same old song. They've been playing defense like this forever. They converge on the ball. They play on a string. They have been a tremendous defensive team for a long, long time.
Early Four Tops reference. I love it as we check in with Evan Washburn.
Landry, you touched on it. All-conference point guard for the Lobos, Donovan Dent, dealing with flu-like symptoms. He came down with the flu yesterday, fought through it in that game. As you can see, talking to head coach Richard Pitino, this was something we knew was going to be an issue in this game. During warm-ups, he was really challenged to even get through those. He started this game, came out early. Obviously, if he's a liability or is not healthy enough to play, they will keep him out. We'll keep an eye on it, guys.
Yeah, Evan, we watched all the warm-ups. He barely did anything. He was trying to stay away from his team. He was on the bench. It does not look good. His house comes up short on the three, but Ledee touched it last.
There's no doubt that'd be a tough loss, but Jalen House can also be a point guard. He had 8 assists yesterday and no turnovers in that game.
So far, the Lobos doing a great job on the glass, out-rebounding the Aztecs 7-1.
Yeah, these are the two best rebounding teams in the league.
Joseph tipped up, and Trammell comes away with it. Third meeting between these two teams. Each team won at home this season, and neither game was particularly close.
They're bringing the heat on Ledee very quickly in this game. Well, we saw him the other day against UNLV. Oh.
And a foul called on Jamal Mashburn Jr.
You know, we saw Ledee the other day draw 17 fouls against UNLV. He's fourth in the nation at free throw attempts a game, almost 9 free throws a game. And they're trying to get to him quickly before he can make a move, which could put them in foul trouble.
Jay Powell at the free throw line. Get into madness today by playing CBS Sports Bracket Games. Enter our men's and women's challenges for the chance to win a Nissan Rogue and trips to the 2025 Final Four. Get the CBS Sports app now to play. San Diego State needed overtime in the quarterfinals to get past UNLV. And then yesterday, they beat the top seed Utah State in a game they were down by 17 points in the first half. It's their largest deficit overcome in 5 years.
They attack double the post and rotate to the strong side.
House misfires and Trammell escapes with the basketball. Ledee has yet to take a shot. They try to feed it there, but a takeaway by Mashburn Jr.
Right now, I have to say, New Mexico has tremendous alertness when it comes to where Ledee is and what they're trying to do.
Ledee out on House. 10 to shoot. Mashburn steps into a three. Book it.
Last year, he was the leading scorer in the league. This year, he's about 15 a game, but he has not shot it as well, which is why his numbers are down. That's a big one for him.
This week, he was 1 of 8 from deep before that three. And we have a tie-up. Good defense by the Lobos. It'll stay with the Aztecs.
You take a look here, Jamal Mashburn's too far away. Trammell was too far away from him and couldn't get to him in time.
Substitutions for both teams.
And you know what, Andrew? Ledee is so important to San Diego State. When he's on the floor, they're 75th in efficiency offensively. When he's out, 310. That's why he's got to be involved in the game.
Yeah, still have yet to see him take a shot. Here's Reese Waters, the USC transfer, and he took too many steps. Third turnover by the Aztecs.
Now the Lobos have four guys that can make a three surrounding Nelly Joseph.
Mashburn goes right around Ledee, draws the contact and the foul.
You don't see people get to the basket this much against San Diego State. The problem is Ledee got burnt again on the switch guarding the smaller guys. This may be something we got to keep watching as the game goes on. They may have to reevaluate all these switches.
8 points already for Jamal Mashburn Jr. So far this week, he averaged 7 points per game. Elijah Saunders, and he has had a rough week, tips it back out to Bird, who saves it to Butler. Saunders is 1 of 11 at the Mountain West Tournament. Butler inside, hangs, misses, tipped up in the air. House has it, turns on the Jets. House trying to go coast to coast, rejected by Bird. Miles Bird getting back on defense.
Great job in the transition defensively.
Waters for three, short, and House will bring it across.
Let's understand this dude, New Mexico. Oh, what a pass.
And a foul is called. Bird thought he had another block.
I mean, like you said, Andrew, House turned the Jets on here, but he got tracked down by Miles Bird. Tremendous block. You know, the one thing that San Diego State doesn't want is for this game to get helter-skelter, because New Mexico thrives on that. They're number 6 in tempo. They want to play as fast as possible. They like steals. They like block shots. They're up in the top 25 in both categories. San Diego State has to run when they can, and when they don't, play half court.
No field goals in the last 4 minutes for San Diego State. We got a matchup of the highest scoring offense in the Mountain West in New Mexico against one of the best defenses in the country, including in the Mountain West in San Diego State.
They're having all kinds of trouble getting it inside.
Bird On the wing, nowhere to go, and House takes it away. House is everywhere. Steps into a three. Let's see if San Diego State can get Ledee a shot. He might just have to do it himself, and he tried to. He draws the foul. Timeout with 11:49 to go in the first half. 16-8, New Mexico. CBS Sports coverage of the Mountain West Championship is sponsored by Jersey Mike Subs. Be a sub above. AT&T, who believes connecting changes everything. And by Allstate, reminding you that basketball season is mayhem. And now it's Inside March Madness, presented by GMC. A look at the tournament resumes for both teams. At the beginning of the week, New Mexico very much considered a bubble team. And today, Jerry Palm has them as a 9 seed.
Well, getting to the championship game here has really made a huge difference. They'll sleep a lot better tonight. They'll sleep perfect tonight if they can win this game.
Moments ago, Evan with Brian Dutcher.
Well, Coach, what do you need to do defensively to change the momentum and slow down what New Mexico's done to start this game?
Well, they've gone inside. We're going to double the post. We didn't double the start, but they made a conscious effort to throw it in. So we'll double a little bit now, try to slow the inside attack, then get more patient offensively.
What about the ball screens up top with their guards?
We're switching them. Can't let them get downhill, but we're switching them, trying not to show them angles.
Coach, thank you.
Thanks.
Well, that was a great question, because that's what I wanted to ask. So we got to keep an eye on that. Right now, they're going to keep switching them. Let's see if New Mexico continues to take advantage of Ledee when he's on one of these guards.
And you see Donovan Dent back on the floor. As Evan told us, he is really struggling with flu-like symptoms today.
I mean, they are surrounding you. Look at this. Look at this.
In the corner for three, it's good for Lamont Butler. He's got a word for Jalen House on his way down the floor.
And that's what needs to happen. If they're going to put three guys on Ledee, somebody's got to be open somewhere, but you got to make shots.
Mashburn Jr., 3-for-11 last night, already 3-for-3 today for 8 points.
My guess is New Mexico's feeling is, I don't think San Diego State can beat us from the three-point line. They've been inconsistent. They shot it good yesterday, but all year, 30% from the three.
Mashburn takes another shot and hits again, and he is hot to start this one.
These guards, they make some tough shots.
Saunders gets one to drop, and that's what the Aztecs need to see happen, as Saunders is such a capable shooter coming off the bench, has struggled all week long, 1 of 10 entering today.
Yeah, he's a very important guy. Coming into this tournament, he was their second best three-point shooter by percentage.
Mashburn, not this time, tipped around, and it's corralled by Waters. He leaves it for Bird. Trammell on the bench right now for San Diego State. Butler in the paint, up fake, and draws the foul.
Well, Lamont Butler is so physically strong. If he gets you on his hip, he's going to be able to make something happen.
San Diego State finished the regular season 4-4. They lost their last two games, heading into the Mountain West Conference Tournament, but there's something about March with this team the last few years. They've been able to flip the switch this week. Tonight at 8:30 Eastern over on CBS Sports Network, it's the Conference USA Championship game as UTEP battles Western Kentucky for a spot in the NCAA Tournament. Butler, the Mountain West Defensive Player of the Year, knocks in the second free throw. Mustafa Amsiel on the wing, defended by Saunders, trying to get around Saunders. He cannot. Now he tries to go with the left-hand wild shot. No good.
Yeah, you got to kick that out. If you have to make five fakes, guess what? The guy's guarding you. Get rid of it.
We are midway through the first half, and Ladie has still not attempted a shot, although he does draw the foul here against JT Toppin.
That's an incredible job with the game plan for New Mexico so far in this game. Their game plan is working, but the problem for them is, I mean, they're up four. San Diego State has made a couple of shots.
But Mountain West's leading scorer goes to the bench with 9:47 to go in the first half. Waters. What a rebound by Heidi, but it was a little too aggressive, and he's called for the foul.
He goes up high for this one, but yes, that's a foul.
There's Jalen House, the son of former Arizona State star Eddie House, who won a title with the Boston Celtics. Eddie is in the house today wearing his son's jersey. Toppin. And it's scooped up by Bird. Miles Bird, the sophomore from Stockton, California, active in the first half. Saunders has the roll on that one.
All of a sudden, he made that first shot before. Now it's a little bounce in his step. That was a pretty bouncy move. Now Heidi's on deck.
House for three. It's good. Jalen House knocks it down, and his big tournament continues in front of his father. Lobos averaging 82 points per game. That's the sixth most in school history. Butler left alone. And the rebound to Toppin. House, instant energy, and instant offense in the first half.
And the crazy thing about this game for them, they're not even running a lot. They're doing a lot of this in the half court.
8 points already for Jalen House. 8 minutes left in the first half as Micah Parrish connects. We asked Richard Pitino before the game about his team playing for the fourth time in 4 days, and he said, well, one guy I know I don't have to worry about in terms of energy is House. He is flying out there.
These guys are young. They're playing in a conference championship game.
Saunders too strong, lost it, and now House wants to run. He's got the speed to do it. Squeezes a pass to Dent, who misses the lay-in. Washington the rebound, but taken away. And now the San Diego State bench is saying, let's go. We got some numbers. Butler out to Parrish. Fakes the three. Now he'll take it. Up and down we go.
And that's what New Mexico wants and likes. Heidi's got House.
House for three again. Timeout, San Diego State. House has scored the last 9 points for the Lobos.
Lobos on fire, getting this thing up and down now. 27-18, knocking the threes down.
Conference Championship Weekend presented by Allstate. Welcome back. Here's a look at our game summary. And New Mexico leads the Mountain West in points off turnovers per game. Off to a great start in that department. And a moment ago, Evan Washburn with Richard Pitino.
Well, Coach, we knew Jalen House would bring it for this game. But defensively, have you kept Ladie in check?
Well, it's been a team effort. We came off strong side too many times, gave up two threes. But you got to swarm him because he can win a game by himself. And I think collectively we've done a pretty good job.
What's the plan with Donovan Dent with the flu-like symptoms?
He's really struggling. He's showing a lot of heart. Feel bad for him. So we're going to try to get him out in and out as much as we can.
Coach, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, the two threes they made were when a guy on a strong side left his man to come and triple him. But I'd rather take a shot on them to making a three than let Ladie beat me because he can't beat you by himself.
How about the San Diego State defense so far?
Yeah, well, you look right here. It's usually you don't get these kind of baskets against San Diego State where there's dribble penetration. Here comes a switch. Ladie gets taken to the basket. You had Heidi just give up a three-point shot to Jalen House. The switching hasn't been great for them, and they've allowed dribble penetration, which is normally impossible against them.
House, last night and so far tonight, 45 minutes, 30 points, 9 assists, and no turnovers. That is winning basketball, and New Mexico trying to win the Mountain West Tournament Championship for the first time in 10 years.
See, he's got to make a quick move.
Ladie's first shot attempt and nowhere close.
If he hesitates at all, they're coming. He's got to catch it and make a quick move.
Ashburn lost it going up in a turnover. Trammell back on the floor for the Aztecs. Corner three for Parrish won't go, and Joseph with the board. Joseph with Powell on him. And a whistle and a foul. And there is Donovan Dent, who we've been talking a lot about, battling the flu, is going to the New Mexico locker room. And as Coach Pitino just told Evan, he's really struggling, and that's obviously a bad sign.
And I mean, he's a second-team All-League player, 15 points a game, one of the top number four in assists in the league. He's a real loss.
9-2 run right now for the Lobos. And falling behind is nothing new for San Diego State. Much of the last 3 weeks they've been falling behind in the first half of games, including by 17 yesterday against Utah State. Brian Dutcher told us we're just getting used to it, unfortunately. Mashburn Jr., another three. And Jack Pitino in the middle. Richard's son loves it.
And that was Ladie, and it was contested hard. He made a tough shot.
It's a 12-2 run, and all 12 of the Lobo points have come courtesy of the triple. Ladie from the outside. And New Mexico is happy if he takes those.
He's trying to get something going. And here's the switch again.
House step back. Man, oh man. House and Mashburn cannot be stopped.
And who was on him that time? Ladie. Ladie was on the three on that one before that too. I don't know about the switching. I know Brian Dutch, he knows his team and they are tremendous defensively, no doubt. But I don't know about today, what's going on.
Nearly a steal by Isaac Mushila. CBS Tomorrow, catch a new episode of the most watched show in the country, starring Justin Hartley. Tracker, it's new tomorrow after The Equalizer on CBS and streaming on Paramount Plus.
I also think San Diego State should start to set some small to big stairs in the D going off the dribble.
And finally, his first field goal of the day.
I was going to say, set some small to big screens for him on the box, too.
Mashburn Jr. and Jalen House have scored the last 22 points for the Lobos. Mushila scrambling for it in the paint. And a tie-up that'll stay with New Mexico. Our final media timeout of the first half. Lobos looking good early in Vegas. Welcome back to the CBS Sports presentation of Conference Championship Weekend presented by Allstate. The Lobos lead by a dozen on San Diego State. Coming up, AT&T at the half, Adam, Clark, Jay, and Seth will have their first half analysis and scores and highlights from around the country. It's all coming up on AT&T at the half. And those bid stealers are still out there. Bubble teams are rooting against these teams.
Rooting against them hard, there's no doubt about it.
8-10 championship game tomorrow will be a bid stealer, Duquesne against VCU at 1 o'clock Eastern time on CBS. Well, New Mexico is up by 12. In every win the Lobos have had this season, they've had a double-digit lead at some point. We'll see if that trend continues with 3:49 to go in the first half.
Well, how about those two guards, Mashburn and House, 26 of the 32 points, 6 points from the rest of the team.
Joseph controls it with the shot clock at three. Mashburn Jr., another three. And a whistle and a foul is called on House. Over to Evan.
And guys, in that last San Diego State huddle, that was the primary focus. The rules that they have going forward on how to defend House, how to defend Mashburn, especially on those ball screens left that you pointed out. And the other thing that they kept saying, hey guys, we were down 17 yesterday. That's been the story for the Aztecs in this tournament. Coming back from deficits usually happens in this 4-minute window going into the break.
Well, and you know one thing too, Evan, the speed that New Mexico likes to play at, they can get back into this thing rather quickly if they can get some transition and get some stops.
Ledee saves it out to Butler for three. Well, and Brian Dutcher has told us this all week, that the run that the Aztecs made in March a year ago has given them a resolve this year. When they know they have to dig down and make a run, they're confident they can do it after everything they went through last year to get to the national championship game.
Well, these guys don't get shook easy, and that's why.
Joseph. And Toppin cleans it up.
Toppin is one of the best offensive rebounders in the entire country. He just has a nose for the ball.
3.5 offensive rebounds per game. That leads the Mountain West. Ledee to the basket. And counted in one. And maybe that's the spark San Diego State needs.
That was a mistake by Nelly Joseph going for the steal here. They've been doing a good job. Watch, he goes for that steal. Now he's out of position. He's got to get help from somewhere, and he gets an and one.
And that's the second foul on Nelly Jr. Joseph. He transferred from Iona, where he played for Rick Pitino, the father of Richard Pitino, who could be a big selection Sunday for the Pitino family. Both the Lobos and the St. John's Red Storm feeling pretty good about their chances.
And you know, it's not one of those deals where there's no way those guys would play each other. There's a chance they could be in Dayton. I don't think so.
That would not be good for the Pitino family.
That would be terrible.
Ledee has scored the last five for San Diego State as we approach 2:20 to play.
And it's good that he got going a little bit here in the first half, making him feel better.
And a reach-in against Trammell.
Richard Pitino has done a great job of taking advantage of these matchups. Like that time, they switched. They had Trammell inside on Toppin, so they tried to get it to Toppin down low.
Rick Pitino stayed back on the East Coast to get St. John's ready for a hopeful NCAA tournament berth. But Richard does have his two brothers and his entire family out here in Vegas, and they watched the St. John's game against Seton Hall, the big win in the quarterfinals. They watched it all together out here in Vegas. Trammell to Powell. Counted and won.
I'll tell you what, that was a heck of a catch and finish.
Fouls on Baker.
Trammell threw a bullet here in close quarters, and Powell does a good job of gathering it and getting the and one. You know, Andrew, to focus in on just how good San Diego State is defensively. They're going to make the NCAA tournament and be only the fifth team in 25 years to make the tournament, being last in their conference in field goal percentage and three-point percentage. That tells you what, they guard because they don't score.
And Brian Dutcher said it so well last night. Our defense is what separates us. We can suffer through a bad offensive performance and hang in there. And that's exactly what they've done in the first half.
And here's the switch again.
Good defense by Parrish. He got a hand on it. A 6-0 run for San Diego State. And Ladie's out of bounds. Trammell says that's on me.
Yeah, that was not a good pass.
And New Mexico calls a timeout with 1:23 to go before halftime. The great athletes from historically black colleges and universities will be on display at the HBCU All-Star Game, Sunday, April 7th, here on CBS. Well, the New Mexico defense has been a big story this week. You see what they did in the regular season defensively compared to their three Mountain West tournament games, giving up just 61 points per game.
Yeah, they've been terrific in this tournament defensively.
Ooh, stop House, and go. What a move. House has 15. Eddie says, let's bring it. 10-point game, 1 minute to play. With D inside, and he's got the touch.
See, that time, they got him on the baseline. They were trying to feed him in the middle of the floor the whole game. That time, they got him on the right box, and he was able to do what he needed to do. They couldn't get a double there fast enough.
7 points in the last 4 minutes for Ladie. And we got about a 10-second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Toppin sets the screen for House. House all the way to the basket, not this time. Ladie over to Parrish with 10 seconds to go.
Did you give it to Trammell?
Yeah, Trammell has hit a buzzer beater to end the first half each of the last two games. He's got the ball here. Dishes to Powell. And that's how the first half ends.
That was a great job by Trammell penetrating into the lane. The help comes to MCL, came too late. Kind of got stuck in no man's land, and they end up getting a dunk. That's a big play to score at the end of the half like that when you've been down the whole game.
New Mexico led by as many as 14, but a 10-2 run by San Diego State. Here's Evan with Richard Pitino.
Well, Coach, this has been San Diego State's script throughout this tournament. Late surge in the first half and then coming out strong in the second. How do you guys avoid that?
Well, you just got to play defense. We got to take better shots. And we got to take care of the basketball. When you let them get out on the break, they're hard to guard. And Ladie, obviously, we got to continue to make a play in the crowd.
In this style of game, what do you think it's going to come down to?
Toughness, both sides, both great teams. We got to match their physicality. They've been doing it for 30 years. We got to step up and do it right now.
Coach, appreciate you.
Thank you.
New Mexico is 24-2 when leading at the half this year. That's the end of the first half. With the score 36-30 in favor of the Lobos, we'll send you to Adam Zucker in our studio for AT&T at the half right after these messages. CBS Sports coverage of the Mountain West Championship is sponsored by Capital One. What's in your wallet? Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. And by Nissan, official partner of March Madness. This is the 12th consecutive Mountain West tournament for me and my guy Lapp. And what a run it's been. We're still here.
Yeah,
but you look the same. I'm the one who looks like he's getting older. I don't get that, you know?
Hey, 12 years in a row here. This is the best we've ever seen this conference.
You know, it's always one of the highlights of my year when I come here, when I get the assignment. I've had the assignment for a long time. I love coming here. This is one of the great conference tournaments in all of college basketball. Thomas and Mack is alive, and this league this year, 16 for the NCAA tournament. You're talking about being right behind the Big 12 and the SEC. Pretty good.
Man, always so lucky to be here. We are happy to be a part of the madness in Vegas at the Mountain West Tournament as we take a look at the Jeep. First half stats, points off turnovers, a big key, 10-0 in favor of New Mexico. And Mashburn and House combined to score 28 of the 36 as we send it over to the third member of the Wolfpack, Evan Washburn.
Good to be with you guys. Perfect transition, Andrew, because that's what I asked Brian Dutcher. How do you slow down House and Mashburn? And he said, look, they're getting the shots we want them to get. They're contested shots. They're just hot right now. We're going to stay the course. They're already above their average in 3 points made in that first half. If they stay hot, we're in trouble. So no sweeping schematic change. And as is always the case, defense and rebounding was top of mind as well.
All right, Evan, you saw Donovan Dent on the bench. It's Jamal Baker who starts the half as Dent only played 9 minutes in the first half, in and out of the lineup as he battles the flu.
Well, you know, Andrew, every game we've seen of the San Diego State, they've scored the last basket of the first half and have rode the momentum of that.
But Butler cannot get the first shot of the second half to go in. 24, the last 26 for the Lobos, courtesy of House and Mashburn.
They run a lot of pick and rolls, this team. 36% of their possessions.
And that one is knocked out of bounds, and Mashburn Jr. a little shaken up.
I mean, that was like a body block there. Let me take a look at this. I got to think that's got to be a foul. You get hit by Lamont Butler, too, on top of it. Forget it.
10 on the shot clock. Joseph trying to work on Ladee. Good defense by Ladee as the shot clock is down to 2. Mashburn Jr. has to put one up. And he hits. And he blows a kiss to the Lobo fans.
Wow, that's a tough shot.
And a turnover by the Aztecs.
I mean, Mashburn just rose up on this. Little bit slow on the screen, stepping up to him.
He's 3 of 4 from deep for 16 points. He was 3 of 11 yesterday in the semifinal win over Colorado State.
You know, I used to tell my guys, if you're going to switch, it's got to be an aggressive switch, not a switch just for the sake of it. You got to switch and not give up a shot.
Baker straight away 3. And the rebound to the corner. Butler could not secure it. It'll stay with the Lobos. New Mexico won each of their first 3 games this week by double digits. First team to ever do that at the Mountain West Conference Tournament. House runner, no. And the rebound to Parrish. 3 for Butler. Not there. And House escapes the pack. Sprinting up ahead. House right at Parrish. Yes.
He had him backpedaling. Nobody was able to stop the ball. He takes it right to the basket.
An 11-point lead. Trammell passes it over to Butler. Another 3. This one goes for Lamont Butler.
Yeah, he shot the ball really well yesterday. He made 3 threes.
16 points in the semifinal win over Utah State. Just the 3rd 3 of the afternoon for the Aztecs. Butler's right on Mashburn. The Mountain West Defensive Player of the Year knocks it free. Mashburn to the ground. Butler scrambling for it. Butler's got it. And a tie-up is called. It'll go back to New Mexico. Let's go over to Evan.
Well, guys, as House and Mashburn continue to dominate this game, it's important to note they were the first two recruits for Richard Pitino. He actually recruited them off of Zoom during COVID. They've set the foundation for this program, the effort, the intensity, the pace in which they play. So if they're able to finish this here in Vegas, it would be a complete full circle moment.
There's no doubt if you want to have a pressing, running, fast-breaking team, you start with those two guys. It's pretty good.
The shot clock is at 2.
Yeah, there was no change of possession there.
So the Lobos have to work quickly. Mashburn gets it. Mashburn trying to put a shot up, forces one up, and that's going to be a shot clock violation. Third season for Pitino at New Mexico, a 60-40 record coming into this one, and he's got the Lobos on the verge of advancing to the NCAA tournament for the first time in 10 years. Parrish fakes the three, now dribbles in and comes up short.
Sometimes you could be too open. That's how he looked there. He looked a little too open. This team runs pick and roll 36% of the times, which is an amazing number, but their best pick and roll guy is not in now, and that's Donovan Dent.
Mashburn for three. Let's see if the Aztecs can get Ladie a touch. Trammell dribbling through traffic, rejected by Joseph.
Yeah, I mean, Ladie got something going at the end of the half, but it's like he's not even in the game now, it seems.
He had 7 points in the final 4 minutes and 9 seconds, but nothing so far here in the second half. Has not even attempted a shot 4 minutes in. He's defending Joseph. Joseph knocked out. Last touch by Joseph. It'll be Aztecs ball when we come back. The Lobo fans, led by Jack Pitino, Richard's son, want to see New Mexico go all the way to a title here in Vegas. Welcome back to the CBS Sports presentation of Conference Championship Weekend. It's presented by Allstate. 15:51 to go, second half. New Mexico has a 41-33 lead. We take a look at the Allstate Conference update, and our Jerry Palm has 6 Mountain West teams in the NCAA tournament. That would be a league record, and it would tie for the most bids by a mid-major all time. The Atlantic 10 years ago had 6 teams, and Conference USA 20 years ago had 6 teams. In and you see the woman there, Gloria Navarez, the commissioner of the Mountain West, and she's been smiling all week long.
Boy, she's been smiling all year.
Yeah, no doubt.
You know, because they had an unbelievable record in the pre-conference season, and they started out with a really good net, and that's what you need to do nowadays.
During the timeout, they reversed the call, and they gave the ball to the Lobos. Mashburn for three. And the rebound to Miles Byrd.
San Diego State has done a decent job on the defensive glass.
Butler misses in tight. Joseph is able to swing it over to Mashburn Jr.
They could use Jamal Baker to make a shot.
Here's Mashburn Jr. on the drive. Off-balance shot, won't go. Tip to Saunders. Still no Donovan Dent this half for New Mexico. Ladie battling Joseph. Now Ladie's got it. Spins around Joseph and gets the bounce.
Quick move. That's what you got to do. That time they got him in the middle of the lane. He decided what he wanted to do quickly. No double comes, scores.
The first points in the last 2.5 minutes. And then House is rejected. And he just got a T.
House didn't get the call, said something to the official, and an immediate tee, and Richard Pitino is livid with his graduate student guard.
Yeah, that's a mistake. I mean, you can't be in the backcourt all by yourself like he was there and say something to the ref who's standing right next to you. Just can't do it.
Second time this season, House has been called for a technical against San Diego State. He also got one at the pit. It's his second foul. Gene Steratore is with us, and Gene, this was a pretty clear-cut call.
Yeah, it was, Andrew. You know, you're frustrated because you get your shot blocked, but looking back and then making those comments to the referee as you're starting down the court, that's usually a technical foul pretty quick, and they addressed it very quick. Nixon addressed it very fast.
Gene Lapp has the same reaction when the dealer flips over a blackjack here in Vegas. Thank you, Gene. Jalen House will sit. We'll see for how long. 41-37.
The D again.
And all of a sudden, it's a two-point game.
We've seen this script before all week.
Donovan Dent back on the floor. A 6-0 run for the Aztecs. Dent is rejected by Bird and numbers the other way as Trammell brings it across. San Diego State has never led in this game. And the D is fouled inside. CBS Tuesday is FBI night with FBI, FBI International, and FBI Most Wanted. New episodes Tuesday starting at 8, 7 Central on CBS and streaming on Paramount Plus. That's a big foul. Joseph picks up his third as House continues to watch.
You know, they were getting to Ladie really quickly in the first half. It started to wane a little bit towards the end of the half. Now they're not getting to him much at all.
Ladie lost it. Good defense. Toppin in the mix.
They need somebody else to score besides Mashburn and House.
Those two have scored 29 of the last 31 for the Lobos. Shot clock at 7. Mashburn looking for more. Too strong off glass. And now we have a whistle and two players down on the ground. Bird and Mashburn Jr. And good sign here as both are up on their feet. Bird is called for the foul, and the Aztecs fans here thought it was a charge.
No, it was not a charge. It was definitely a... That was the new rule perfectly. He was not there before that last foot was planted, and he hit him on the side. He didn't even hit him square. That's a good call.
So Mashburn's banged up. House is on the bench after the technical, and Dent is sick. As New Mexico plays its fourth game in 4 days. There's always more to see on a mountain of entertainment. Catch new Champions League matches, a huge new season of Halo, and blockbuster movies like Mission Impossible Dead Reckoning, now streaming on Paramount Plus.
Andrew, I think San Diego State is really starting to wear on these guys a little bit.
Mashburn Jr. still grimacing as he plays defense against Trammell. A steal by Amseel with Waters back. Amseel is fouled. The Mountain West Coast Sixth Man of the Year getting it done on the defensive end.
Yeah, that was really not a good pass. It was a good play by Amseel, no question, but really a bad pass.
Let's check in with Evan.
And Andrew, as you lay out the fatigue factor for both teams, really, but New Mexico, they had the late game last night, so they didn't leave the arena till after midnight. So that was this morning. Didn't get to bed until closer to 1. And talking to Brian Dutcher with San Diego State, having been a part of this game so many years in a row, he said there's a portion here in the second half where fatigue settles in for both sides, and the team that's able to push through that is the one that's cutting down nets.
And Evan, Brian Dutcher has said he thinks it's one of the toughest turnarounds in college basketball, conference tournament time. Played a late semi here in Vegas late last night to a 3 o'clock local tip today.
And playing with one less important guy.
House is back on the floor. Waters turn around from the baseline. It goes, and the foul.
Really tough shot by Waters. Backs his man down.
Waters did not come into the Mountain West tournament playing very well. He only had 2 points then in the quarterfinals against UNLV, but he went for 11 last night. And Brian Dutcher told us before the game, maybe he's going to start heating up at just the right time. That was a big shot there for the Aztecs.
And he did it on Donovan Bent.
A 91% free throw shooter, and now Mashburn is getting attended to next to the New Mexico bench. And this is as loud as we've heard it at the Thomas and Mack Center.
Toppin has been a non-factor in terms of the offense.
Washington for three. Too strong. The long rebound is tracked down by Trammell.
Not a good three-point shooter, but he was open.
New Mexico has not trailed tonight, only 43 seconds the entire tournament. And then a foul is called. That's on Toppin, his second.
Yeah, that's a foul, but I mean, I think on the other end, they got to get Toppin more involved in this game because he's the one guy who is capable of doing something inside. He's not doing anything.
In two games against San Diego State this year, Toppin had two double-doubles. Waters, okay, here we go. And San Diego State has its first lead of the day. House trying to quiet the Aztecs fans. He can't get it to drop, and Bird the rebound. Saunders transition three. Off the front of the rim, House grabs it, and Saunders commits the foul. And that takes us to a timeout. But the Aztecs have come back.
Not only they come back all the way. Aztecs, 1 point lead.
Conference championship weekend presented by Allstate. We're back, and let's take a look at the fast analysis presented by AT&T.
Well, take a look at how they converged on Ladie in the first half. He didn't score for the first 15 minutes of this game. And then you see in the second half, look at this. He catches the ball in the lane, and everybody's standing around watching him. Nobody gets to him. He takes Nelly Joseph like he's not even there. And now he's back in the game. There's no coincidence that when he was not scoring, New Mexico had their biggest lead in the game.
On the other end, New Mexico without a field goal over the last 6 minutes and 20 seconds. And over the last 24 minutes of game action, they've only had one field goal by someone other than House or Mashburn.
And you know, you had to think, and this is what San Diego State does. They're a physical defensive team. They wear you out to shoot well against them for 40 minutes. And these guards are a little diminutive in terms of their physicality.
And Mashburn is still on the sideline as Amseel misses the three. Evan, what are you seeing with Mashburn Jr.?
Yeah, it appears to be his lower back. Remember, took a nasty fall, did some work with the athletic training staff trying to stretch it out. You mentioned he remains on the sideline. Clear discomfort, but did give Coach Pitino a head nod like, I'm good. Guys, Richard Pitino wants more pace. Doesn't like them walking the ball up the floor. But again, that fatigue factor is part of this.
And you got to make stops, too. You know what I mean? If you're going to push the ball, you got to get stops and you got to get rebounds.
And on cue, Mashburn Jr. back in for Donovan Dent, who continues to struggle under the weather the last 48 hours. And he's going to go to the end of the bench. Byrd for three. Ledee with the offensive rebound. He's a monster in there. Look at this. And he scores. So strong. ...16-2 run, and New Mexico has missed its last 9 field goal attempts.
They got nobody to throw the ball inside to. They got to try something.
Mashburn Jr. draws the foul. How about the work down low by Jaden Ledee?
I mean, he had a lot of red shirts around him. Look at this, getting bumped. Shot fake. Yes, he is right.
Ledee is 6 for 8, and he's made his last 6. Mashburn Jr., the son of Jamal Mashburn, who played 12 years in the NBA and played at Kentucky for Rick Pitino.
Oh, yeah, I saw him firsthand.
CBS Wednesday, Survivor is back. It's a supersized season with the most surprising, unexpected, and unorthodox cast yet. Don't miss a new Survivor Wednesday, 8, 7 Central on CBS and streaming on Paramount Plus.
Cardinal Hayes High School in the Bronx.
Is he another one that got away?
Yeah. Wait, you know.
Well, I just want to know where we are with your list.
It's long. Too long.
10.5 to go. Bird. Off glass, no. The scramble. House is in the middle of it, and Joseph with 3 fouls picks it up. Then Ledee takes it away, and a foul is called on Ledee.
Wow. I don't know.
They second.
It's a foul. It is in. It's a foul. I was going to complain because I thought the wrong referee called it. There was a ref under the basket that didn't call it. It got called from way outside, but it was a foul.
Each team with 5 fouls here in the second half. Good hustle out there for Miles Byrd, whose father, Calvin, did play for you at Villanova, so I don't always talk about the ones that got away.
I inherited Calvin. He was a senior when I got the job.
He didn't leave.
No, he didn't leave. He stayed, thankfully.
Baker for 3.
Wow, these shots that they're taking.
Aspern Jr. right in the paint, and the foul. So New Mexico has missed its last 10 field goal attempts. But there's your man, Calvin Byrd, who played for you at Villanova for a year.
Yeah, great kid. He was a coach at Pacific for a long time, too. He was a McDonald's All-American. Played for me his senior year at Villanova, my first year there.
It's kind of crazy. You got Mashburn's kid, Eddie House's kid, Calvin Byrd's kid in this game.
What are you trying to say?
I'm right there with you.
Trying to say something.
I feel it too. And Richard Pitino, the son of Rick Pitino, the head coach at New Mexico, with Mashburn Jr. putting the Lobos back in front by 1. Incredible atmosphere here in Vegas. Ledee has an opening and a wedgie on the jam, but a foul. And it's hard to get it stuck there. That's talent. Meanwhile, the foul, more importantly, is on Joseph.
Yep, 4.
Which is his 4th, and all the fans and Richard Pitino think that was all ball.
Look at that. I haven't seen that either.
That's a big call. Joseph with his 4th. You've been talking about the lack of an inside presence. And now with 9:50 to go, Joseph's going to have to come out.
He hasn't been a real offensive presence, but at least defensively he's a bigger body in there. But I really believe if they're going to go 4 out, 1 in, and Toppin is in, they got to throw the ball to the block 1 time. They haven't thrown it inside this entire second half.
New Mexico doesn't have a field goal in 8 minutes and 14 seconds, yet we're still tied for the moment. Now the Aztecs up 1. New Mexico led by as many as 14 in the first half. House directing traffic, 10 on the shot clock. House at the free throw line, goes up and hits.
Tough shot with the D on him. The D did a pretty good job that time of defending him.
19 for House. He also had 19 in the semifinals last night. And that ends the 8 minute and 40 second field goal drought for New Mexico. The D is fouled on the drive on the floor. That was Toppin who got him. That'll be a 1-1 for San Diego State with 9:06 to play. Third foul on Toppin.
That's concerning because they don't really have another big guy that plays a significant amount.
Ledee makes it, and you see his family is in attendance here at the Thomas and Mack. Herb Ledee, his father, Houston native, Jaden, who started his collegiate career at Ohio State for 1 year and then 2 years at TCU. Now in his second year, plus a redshirt season at San Diego State.
And what we haven't talked about, he's one of the most improved players in the country. He averaged 8 points a game last year. Now he leads the Mountain West, and he's third in rebounding.
And he has set a new single season scoring record tonight at San Diego State, surpassing Michael Cage's record from the 83-84 season. Meanwhile, the Aztecs foul will send New Mexico to the line for a 1-1 as Trammell picks up his second.
At the line, number 10, Jalen House.
House makes the first free throw, and he's got 20 points for the ninth time this year. Lobos back up one. We've had 6 lead changes in the last 3 minutes and 16 seconds.
And I think this is a good move by Richard Pitino. He doesn't have JT Toppin on the D.
It's Isaac Mushila who's defending the D. They are tangled up down low, and that didn't get very far before the whistle sounded.
He's starting to draw those fouls again.
So the D is back at the free throw line. Drew 17 fouls on Thursday in the quarterfinals against UNLV. And he is 6 for 6 at the line tonight. Aztecs have made their last 12 free throws in a row, and it's a 1-point San Diego State lead with 8:40 to go in the second half. You're watching the Mountain West Championship game on CBS. House and Trammell dives to the ground. House comes away with it. House over to Mashburn Jr. for three. And that is Parrish going to get the rebound.
Yeah, they were fortunate there. He was wide open because of that loose ball on the other side.
Ledee has scored the last 8 for San Diego State. Do they go to him again?
Yes.
He is battling Mushila down low.
He's got a guy 6'4 on him.
And there's the foul. And this is the problem when Joseph picked up his 4th foul.
And they don't want to put Toppin on him because he's got 3.
And he's going deep into his bench with Sebastian Forsling A junior from Sweden is going to try to give them some size down low. He's played in just 20 games this year.
This kid's coming into a tough spot. If he's going to guard, I'm sure he's guarding the D also. The D went from not being in the game in the first half to dominating the game.
Forsling has played a total of 3 minutes this week.
This is going to be baptism by fire.
Ladie has scored the last 9 points for the Aztecs. And Richard Pitino told us before the game that Ladie, and it's not a knock on the officials, but he's a difficult guy to officiate. And a lot of what Richard Pitino was telling us was, how is this game going to be called?
Well, 100% he's a tough guy to officiate because he's so physical.
Seven on the shot clock. Mashburn Jr. going right at Trammell. Up and no. Toppin had the board out of bounds. It'll be New Mexico basketball when we come back. Well, like father, like son, Richard Pitino getting animated, but not as much as his son, Jack. CBS Sports coverage of the Mountain West Championship is sponsored by GMC. We are professional grade. Buffalo Wild Wings, Let's Go Sports Bar. And by Allstate, reminding you that basketball season is mayhem. Great time of year in Vegas, college basketball time. And right now, 54-51 in favor of the Aztecs. Tomorrow, well, it's a massive day on CBS. It all starts with Inside College Basketball at noon Eastern. Then the A-10 men's championship game, followed by the Big Ten men's championship game. And that all leads up to the selection show tomorrow at 6 Eastern, right here on CBS. Here's a look at the teams that are already in by virtue of the automatic bid. And we're about to add another one here, either San Diego State or New Mexico. We are just over 22 hours away from having a bracket in our hands.
And now Ladie getting a little rest. Oh, no, he's still, yes, no, he's still in.
And out of the timeout, the Lobos are able to connect. Ladie has done a great job getting to the line. 8 free throw attempts in the last 2 minutes and 15 seconds. And now he's got Forsling trying to blanket him. Parrish will take a three and knock it down. First three of the night for Micah Parrish. Prior to tonight, he was 1-for-10 from deep in the Mountain West tournament. House sends it out to nobody. Washington tracks it down.
How about Toppin's taking 4 shots this entire game?
Washington can't hit the jumper. Toppin, there he is. For you, Lapp.
Yeah, I mean, I know he gets an offensive rebound, but throw him the ball once in a while.
That was the 11th offensive rebound for New Mexico. They averaged 12 and a half per game, which is tops in the Mountain West. Butler to Ladie. Over Forsling. No. Oh. The tip by Powell. No. Another tip. No. So Jay Powell had a couple of cracks at it, but it goes back to the Lobos. Housed off balance shot, but Toppin is there again, and we're tied at 57.
Tough shot by House, but Toppin doing what he really does well.
8 points, 8 rebounds for JT Toppin. New Mexico trying to remove all doubt and get the automatic bid from the Mountain West. Ledee with four swing on him. Ledee goes around him to the basket. There's the foul with the shot clock at 7.
Well, you knew what Ledee was going to do here. He was going to go one-on-one on Forsling. How about this kid? He drew 3 fouls in the first half. He has now drawn 10 for the game.
At the line, number 13, Jaden Ledee.
11 for 18 in the quarterfinal win over UNLV, and he was visibly frustrated after some of those misses, but he's turned it around in the last two games. One of 5 finalists for the Karl Malone Power Forward of the Year Award.
You know, you got to give San Diego State credit. They kept the tempo down. This is a high scoring New Mexico team, likes to play fast. They've got 57 points with 5:33 to go in the game. This is gone at San Diego State's grinding pace.
Lobos average 82 per game. One more for Jaden Ledee. And the Aztecs have now made their last 16 free throws in a row. And Brian Dutcher calls a timeout with 5:33 to go. Lobos down by 2. Conference Championship Weekend is presented by Allstate, reminding you that basketball season is mayhem. All eyes on the Mountain West Championship game right now. As we take a look at our game summary, the free throws for the Aztecs. They've made 16 in a row and are 17 out of 19 on the day.
And now with what they're doing on offense, which is looking at Ledee every time down, puts tremendous pressure on the New Mexico defense.
At what point do you bring back Joseph with 4 fouls?
Gets under 4.
Nelly Jr. Joseph has been sitting with 4 fouls for the Lobos. 5:33 on the clock. Over to Evan.
Brian Dutcher took that timeout to clean up their defense, saying it's Jalen House just driving and then the offensive boards are the concern. A number of times, we rebound, we win this championship. That was the message.
Yeah, Toppin had those 2 in a row.
Baker, not with the left hand, knocked out to San Diego State.
Now Amseal is going to take a turn on the D.
The D and Amseal are banging away in the paint. The D calling for it. He's got it. Lost his footing over to Butler. Butler sends it out. Parrish extra pass. Shot clock at 4. Into the corner it goes to Butler for 3. Saunders the offensive rebound. Butler drives right back in. Whoa. High off the glass. No.
Something.
Brian Dutcher cannot believe there was not a whistle. 5-on-4 the other way. House draws the foul. And Brian Dutcher not happy with that sequence of events.
Yeah, I mean, from my vantage point, it looked like Butler took a heck of a shot. That's a foul for sure.
And here's Butler on the other end.
Huh? Not as much as I thought.
House with 2 free throws. And True Washington, the freshman from Phoenix, is back on the floor replacing the 25-year-old Jamal Baker. Tied at 59. And the fans rise at the Thomas and Mack Center. It's been a banner year for the Mountain West, and the final Mountain West Conference game of the year is coming right down to the wire. Ledee off the front of the rim and the rebound to Washington.
You'll take your chances with him doing that. At least you don't have to follow him on that.
Seven lead changes, seven ties, all here in the second half as we're inside four to play. Mashburn Jr. over Ledee is an air ball. Butler lets it go out of bounds. And we've got our final media timeout. What a fitting end to an incredible year in the Mountain West. All tied with 3:51 to go. Now it's time for the Capital One rewarding performance, and Jaden Ledee with 23 points after going scoreless in the first 15 minutes.
Yeah, 23 points in 21 minutes. So they really have been able to get it to him. He's obviously made his free throws and put tremendous pressure on the defense. Now Nelly Joseph is back in under four. And they brought, now obviously, they're going to go to Ledee because they've been looking for him this whole half.
He has drawn 10 fouls and is 11 for 11 from the line. Let's see how Joseph does against him with 3:45 to go. Knocked away by Joseph. House transition three. Won't go, and the rebound to Ledee. New Mexico has three timeouts remaining. San Diego State with two. Brian Dutcher calling out a play from the San Diego State bench.
Aggressive switch by House.
House is all over him. Trammell through the defense and had it taken away by Toppin.
You know, House had a lot to do with that turnover. He was harassing him.
House will reset.
Well, here comes that high pick and roll. The D's gonna switch. Nope, Trammell stays with him.
Here's Joseph with the shot clock at six. Joseph out to Washington. He drives in the paint. Washington, no. And the rebound by Toppin as the shot clock was expiring.
They're going to look at it.
They will take a look.
I think it was good.
I think so, too. Out of his hand, you still see one on the timer. And you think this would be a pretty quick review. Toppin with 10 points and 9 rebounds. So he's a rebound away from his 12th double-double of the year, which is the most in the country among freshmen.
And you know, he looks to me like he could do more. I mean, he's got 3 offensive rebounds this half and scored. He had a nice move in the first half when they got it to him.
The review was for a shot clock violation. The ball did get off in time. Basket's good.
And Vern Harris telling us that it's a 2-point New Mexico lead. Second chance points, 14-4 in favor of New Mexico. And now let's see what San Diego State does with the basketball. They've turned it over on back-to-back possessions. Waters comes back in the game and Parrish goes to the bench.
Trying to get a little bit more perimeter shooting in the game. Maybe open up the floor for Ledee a little bit more.
Waters jumper. And Toppin now has the double-double.
I don't think that's what Brian Dutcher wanted. It wasn't a bad shot.
A 5-minute field goal drought for the Aztecs. They trail by two. House has had the hot hand right from the start. So is Mashburn Jr. with the shot clock down to two. House has to put up a three off the front of the rim. And Joseph the rebound, and Ledee fouls him. What a rebound by Joseph.
I don't think that
New Mexico knew how much time was on the shot clock.
Look at this rebound with one hand.
Oh, yeah, that's
Ledee all over him.
That's
now,
an easy one.
It's a 1-1 for Nelly Jr. Joseph, who's a 53% free throw shooter.
This is one of those ones, you're Richard Pitino, you'd be really happy with the first one.
And he knocks it through. Jack Pitino approves.
If San Diego State doesn't get the ball into Ledee's hands, something's wrong.
One out of two, but top in the offensive rebound.
You don't have to foul. You don't have to go crazy. You got to play solid defense, but you got to get a rebound.
His sixth offensive rebound for JT Toppin. House with five. House off glass for two. And it's a two-possession game. And they call the foul on the Aztecs. Trammell picks up his fourth. Just grazed the top of his head.
Yeah. Could have let that go.
And now eight straight points for the Lobos.
Well, they got to score, take it to the basket, get it into Ledee, and set up your pressure, call timeout and set up your pressure.
It feels like all of Albuquerque is in the Thomas and Mack Center right now.
You got to get it into this guy.
Instead, Ledee sets the screen. Now Trammell will pop a three. And the rebound is knocked out of bounds. And it's Lobo's ball, but they'll take a look.
Yeah, they got to take a look at that one.
Trammell had a good look at that three. And then on the loose ball scramble, who touched it last?
We're going to the monitor to check and see who the ball went out of bounds on.
Might have been Jay Powell.
Yeah, I think it was Powell.
Did it touch the finger of Toppin after Powell knocked it out? I think that'll be the question. Gene Steratore, how do you see this?
I've got it off of Powell, too, but, boy, this is where you really do appreciate the fact that we can look at these because they're really so close and it's such a big play. But I've got it going off of Powell, guys.
Yeah, I agree. It just goes to show you how hard these plays were to referee. I'm being nice to the refs now. But
I can't believe what I'm hearing.
How hard this was to referee without being able to go to the monitor. You're guessing. You have no idea.
Gene, where was this sentiment 20 years ago from Lapis?
You know, I'm not usually speechless, Andrew, but at this point, listening to Coach Lapp be so empathetic, I really am speechless right now, man. Guys.
The Oscars were last week, right? Well, the call on the court is New Mexico basketball. So they'd have to see something conclusive on this review to change the call.
Two things happened in this game. San Diego State stopped scoring, which we've seen a lot from them, and JT Toppin dominated the offensive glass and changed everything.
And for the Aztecs, to your point, over the last 6 minutes, they are 0 of 8 from the floor. These Lobos fans have been partying in Vegas all week, and what a week it's been for New Mexico. Most of the experts say they are in the field, but they would sleep a lot better, and they would certainly celebrate if they could get this victory today.
But I gotta be honest with you, if a review's taking this long,
yeah, I agree.
I think you gotta say the call on the floor stands because there's nothing we can see to overturn it.
I think they were also just double-checking the clock. Here we go.
The call is confirmed on the court. It's red ball, and there's 1:05 on the game clock.
So they put a second back on the clock. Thank you, Gene.
I would not foul here. I know it's a 6 point with 105. I would play solid defense, get a rebound, push it up. I would not foul here. And obviously, you're New Mexico, you're holding this ball. And then you go with like seven to go. Run the high pick and roll.
House will pull it out. Butler, the Mountain West Defensive Player of the Year, right on House.
Here comes the pick and roll.
House over to Washington.
Now you got to shoot.
Shot clock at three. The dish to Toppin. He's got it!
What a great possession.
Executed to perfection. Ledee rejected by Joseph. And it's getting hot in here.
I mean, he drives in at the end of the shot clock. All the help is on him. And they get a layup. And a great block there.
Waters, quick three, won't go. And the rebound right to Ledee, who puts it down, and Brian Dutcher calls timeout. With 21.9 on the clock, it's a 6 point game. Tonight on CBS begins with the 55th annual NAACP Image Awards, hosted by Queen Latifah. That's followed by 48 hours tonight on CBS.
This got to be set up the pressure. Don't let Jalen House get the ball if you can help it, and foul immediately. You have no time to spare for a double team or anything else.
Washington gets it into Toppin, and Powell commits the foul. And Toppin, a 57% free throw shooter.
San Diego State could not have done that any better. They did a great job of not letting House get the ball. Lamont Butler was on him. The guy they wanted to get it, got it.
Well, it was House and Mashburn in the first half. And to your point, Steve, it's been Toppin down the stretch. And now big free throws coming for the freshman from Dallas, Texas.
They got to get this rebound and push it. And they have, and then call timeout again.
One out of two. That makes it a three possession game.
Yeah, that helps.
Butler.
Got
to
shoot.
Over to Powell. He puts up the three. Doesn't get the bounce and tipped out of bounds. It'll be San Diego State basketball. Only 10 seconds remain.
This thing is over.
Waters, no. Ledee, the rebound. Butler for three, and the Lobos, who started the week on the bubble, just put their name in the bracket. Over to Evan Washburn.
I'm getting mobbed here. Jalen, you just won a Mountain West Conference Championship. I got a trophy.
We're not going home. We're not going home.
Good job!
You're going home with that trophy. How did you guys win 4 games in 4 days?
Like I said before, we wanted more. We planned for something more. That's what happened. Let's go.
What do we need to know about New Mexico as you guys now head to the NCAA tournament?
We got a full train of steam coming. Watch out.
What makes this group special, Jalen?
Everybody wants it more. Like I just said, we playing hard. We won it. We rebounded. We defended. We playing physical. Let's do this, man.
When San Diego State came back in this game, how were you guys able to hold them off?
Just stay the course. Stay the course. Stay the course of the game. And just try to... I don't even know what to say right now. I'm just so happy.
Go enjoy it, Jalen. Congrats.
First Mountain West tournament title in 10 years, and the Lobos are going dancing once again. Tonight on CBS begins with the 55th annual NCAA Image Awards. For Steve Lapis, Evan Washburn, Gene Steratore, our entire crew, Andrew Catalan saying so long from Vegas.
Direct your attention to center court for our 2024 Men's Basketball Awards presentation and our host, Jen.
All right, well, we just want to say congratulations to both New Mexico and San Diego State for their outstanding tournament runs. But now it is time for the ultimate honor as Mountain West Commissioner Gloria Navarez presents the 2024 Mountain West Men's Basketball Championship Trophy to Richard Pitino and the New Mexico Lobos. Coach, this was a hard-fought battle. What were some of the key strategies to this win tonight?
We just had to battle. You know, we have so much respect for San Diego State. We battled, obviously, to win 4 games in 4 days was amazing. High-character kids who just fought. They're a great team. It's been so much fun, such a joy.
And this is your first win since 2014. How proud are you of these guys?
It's why I came here. I believe it's a special fan base. It's why these guys come here. And they're champions. It's amazing.
Well, thank you, Coach. Congratulations. All right, and now it is time to announce the MVP. With 28 points, 5 rebounds, 1 assist, emotions right now. What is going through your head? What are you feeling?
I mean, when we first got here, we were 5-23 the previous season. Then our first year, we were 13-17. Last year, we won like 23 games. I mean, we fought so hard to get to this moment. I'm so happy right now.
How special is it for you to win the MVP award?
It feels great. I mean, I put my heart and soul into this game. I love this game. First and foremost, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Lord and Savior. Without him, none of this is possible. Thank you.
Congratulations. And now it is time to punch the ticket for the Big Dads. Your New Mexico Lobos will represent the Mountain West in the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament. Fans, give it up! Punch that ticket right there!
Utah State, great hustle.